Good morning, my friend. How are you today?
I'm doing well, thank you, myself. Now, I know I promised today's video was going to be, or at least the next video was going to be the 25,000 mile owner's review of a Royal Enfield Bullet 500 Forest Green Edition known as Daisy Bell. But there's been a slight snag in that plan in that, hey, Mark, that's bright and blinding.
Understatement of the century, you'd think that after 2 years running the YouTube channel, I'd have my GoPro settings down flat and have no problems with them, but as you can see, as I just found in editing, all the GoPro footage is a bit overexposed, so bear with, won't happen again. Fortunately, most of this video takes place from a different camera point of view.
There's been a slight snag in that plan, in that I went a bit overboard with the script for it, and there were a lot of points I want to cover, and I didn't quite get all the footage I wanted yesterday, so expect that to be the video after this, next weekend when I get out and film the rest of the review. I also have a nice new leather jacket on the way, so half the review I'll be in this jacket and half the review I'll be in the new one. And hopefully it's a good match to me old bullet. But just to tide you over, here's a real quick preview of that review.
The most common question I get on my channel is, what exhaust do I use?
Fascinating stuff, right? But for today, what are we doing? Well, we're going to do something different and perhaps a series that might continue over the summer. And we're going to my cousin's house, Patrick. Now, I've mentioned him a few times in the channel, but today will be the first time you see him in the flesh, I suppose. Sunday drives, I guess we might call it, something to that effect. They're probably not all going to be on Sundays. What are we going to be doing? Well, Patrick and his father, Pat, are vintage car enthusiasts. And they have a nice shed out here in the countryside in Waterford where they have a sort of museum of all their cars. And there's even an old BSA, some little 125 thing they have there too that I believe Patrick's brother Sean got taken over, but I don't think it's running. But it might be nice to go to the garage, bring Daisy, and escort one of the vintage cars around out to Dunmore East or somewhere and have a little chat about it. I hope that interests you. Chances are, if you're interested in the Royal Enfield Bullet 500, you'd be interested in vintage auto cars. Leave a comment below about what you think after the review. Did you enjoy this? Without further ado, let's hop in and have a little look. Well, there's today's auto car. A 19-somethings Mercedes, but hopefully Patrick can tell us more about it. Beautiful, no? Greetings. Woof. Apologies, I'm a bit late. Everyone, this is Patrick. Patrick, shake hands with everyone.
Oh, are you part of it?
Yeah.
This one, of course, is the BSA killer.
There we have amps.
Badge nice sitting there.
Badges, I'll have to take all my sellotape at the moment.
There you go.
Fridge magnet.
What type of car is it?
W123.
And it's a 1976
Mercedes.
That's the only bad part.
That's disgraceful.
I know.
That's about it.
There's nothing else to it.
No.
It's a fairly boring car.
That's the original interior.
That's good.
Yeah. It's great.
Really?
That's four wheels.
And what's the 250 refer to?
I think it's another. It's W123 and there's another model number as well with it.
So it's the incorrect boot on it then, is it?
Or... Yeah.
Oh. So it's not all matching. Let's take a look at the engine. Oops. So this is a 2.8 litre engine. It's got the whole shebang in there. Carburetor.
Dual carburetors.
Dual carburetors. And what else can you tell me?
It has a battery. And
it drinks petrol.
It drinks it.
It takes water and... petrol and...
If you put the shoe down, you can see the need to move.
Oh, God.
Well, enough dawdling around here. We'll have a closer look at the other cars another day. But for now, let's go try out this Mercedes and see what happens, I guess.
Bear in mind, this is the first video of this series, so I'm a bit all over the place as to what the content is. Let me just say bye to Sean here, who's spraying the bonnet for the other car. We're off now, so see you next time. Bye. Jeez. I hope that's water and not oil she's leaking. Off we go to Dunmore East, which is a nice little seaside town. Unlike Daisy, the Mercedes there is a fuel guzzler, so we need to actually get some fuel for it. I really should have studied up on these things before I left, because I can't remember, is it a petrol or a diesel car? But what I can tell you is that it's a lovely old classic car. I'm a big fan of the black and white wrenches like that one ahead. They really add a lot. In fact, Daisy used to have one of them, but before I went to Europe, I switched her over to having the EU approved one, because I just wanted to mitigate the risks that I could be stopped by a policeman and then, or a gendarme, and then perhaps you might have an issue with the front plate as well, because that's technically a no-no. I don't know. Where's the... Oh! I was wondering why you were parking so far from the pump. What a great sound.
Onward we go. So you just put in €20 exactly there, which is a skill to be admired. So next time on whatever series you might call this, I think this camera is frozen again. Oy vey. But next time on whatever series you might call this, I'd open to suggestions, because this would be like a sort of other little mini series on the channel. But I think that's recording a time lapse. That'll be interesting. So next time on this mini series, or whatever you might call this, we'll be taking a closer look at that Essex Super 6 as it takes its maiden voyage out to Tramore. And hopefully Sean can tell us a little bit about the car and what it took to get it running again, the history of it, and it should be good fun. Now, I should also say, in case I haven't already said this, myself and Patrick are planning a long weekend trip to Wales in a couple of weeks. So I'd love your suggestions for any places that we should visit. I'll be on good old Daisy here. He'll be on not the Mercedes, but some other car. And yeah, let me know in the comments if there's anywhere in particular that I should visit during my time there, or places that we should stay. I'm open to anything. We are hoping to see some old steam engines at some point on this trip. So hopefully somewhere in close proximity to places like Tallinn Railway, or however you pronounce it, would be most appreciated. Hopefully too, as these videos go on, the weather will slowly improve, and it's not bad weather today, mind you, but it's very cold. I wouldn't say no to a bit more heat in it. As you can see though, it's one of these kind of Ballymore-esque towns. Little different painted townhouses. It's a lovely place. I actually do have some friends that live out this way, so just a quick hello to Heather and Ross if you are watching this video. You live in a beautiful little town. So Dunmore East is a harbour. It's got a great big lighthouse out here, and it's got a big fishing harbour, and I think, what do you call it? A place where they used to launch boats from. There's still the train tracks that they would have been launched from. God, I really need to do research before I do these videos, because I completely forget what the name of that is. Actually, I think there is an old World War II pillbox up here, which we'll come and have a look at in a much future video, when I'm exploring Ireland during World War II. But for now, this is just a pleasant Sunday drive, isn't it? Just down this way, actually. Now there's someone's vehicle over there. And it's gonna circle around. To park nicely. I don't know what I'm at. I'm just gonna park in here beside you, like this. And we'll leave it in gear, so it doesn't roll.
Some people have an obsession with these as well, about the way they close the sound off. It's quite a nice satisfying thump, to be fair. Patrick's been kind enough to offer to let me drive this Mercedes around the harbour here. So, why don't we take it for a little spin? Where does the key go? It goes in the key ignition. Now what?
Put down a little bit on it. Put down a little on the accelerator and then turn the key.
Accelerator
just,
is the right one or the left one?
Right.
Okay,
your left foot does nothing in this car.
Yeah. And now what do I do?
Turn it clockwise. There you are.
So I want to put it into drive. This is the old Prindle. Take my foot off the accelerator and put her into the drive, right?
Yep. So clip Daisy Bell.
Now I'm very new to driving. I'm on my learner's permit, but so let's take a little trip down to the harbour. So have a look forward. Isn't that lovely having the Mercedes? What do you call it? If I flip this down, is that indicating right? Yeah.
Yep.
Do I have to hold it then?
Nope.
Okay. And does it auto stop?
Yeah.
What did you say it's called when you're launching the boats off the dry dock?
Launching. Or floating it out.
Yeah. Again, I'm very new to driving.
Let's take a left.
Yeah. I'm not used to having all this extra space on my left.
Watch the...
But this car, as someone that's driven exactly one other car, this hard car drives like a dream.
It really does.
So these are those kind of fish and train tracks I was telling you about. Let's just stop you for a second. If you look on the left, there's kind of the frame that the ships would be carrying in. And down here is an adventure centre, I think, where back in school days we would have gone sea kayaking. The lighthouse across the way there is a beautiful sight.
It's down there.
Lowish tide today.
Now imagine Bullet wandering in this car. What would you call it? Mercedes Wanderer?
Merc Club.
Merc Club Wanderer. And how come there's no...
It's very noise, faint. Isn't
it? Let me just see, can you hear them?
Push it down.
Just
push down a tight
note.
Is it?
Yeah, it's on.
Very embarrassing if I clip those plant pots here and just soil your fabulous Mercedes at the end of this video. Oof.
Now, were automatic cars a new thing back in the 70s, or had they been around since before that?
They would have been around in the US probably since the 50s or so.
Yeah.
They wouldn't have been as popular as much in UK or Ireland.
Right.
So this would have been a rarity back in its day, even though this only came over from England in 2007.
We are back at the Daisy Bell. So if I want to park in behind her or beside her like you have it.
Just a break.
And
maybe we're going to put it into reverse.
That's not engaged. I think that's neutral. There you go. Just let go of the brake. It lives itself kind of anyway, if you're not accelerating.
No, I'm just gonna park as safe as I can here against the wall.
And then we put her into P for park.
Mm-hmm. And turn off the key.
Excellent.
Oh. Actually, just one last thing before I head off into the sunset. I always said that when my channel became a bit bigger, I'd start doing shoutouts for little channels. And I know I'm only about 1,400 subscribers at the moment, but at the same time, I would like to give a shout out to a channel called Curly Wolf. This is a channel that's relatively new. It's a guy named Tyler, I believe, and his friend Jake, and he rides a Royal Enfield Himalayan. His girlfriend rides a classic 350, and recently they've gotten an old Honda, and they're kind of... They remind me of myself because they don't know anything about fixing bikes, so they're going to take us through the journey of restoring this bike to its former glory. And also his friend Jake, I think, doesn't have a full bike license, so it's that journey too. But either way, it's worth having a look, and I hope that you leave him a few comments and subscribe to him, because it's good to share the love, you know what I mean? But anyways, bottom line is, as the channel gets bigger, I'll give little shout-outs here and there, because shout-outs from people like Saddlebags and the All Your Motorcyclists is what got me sort of a bit of traction going. Anyways, back to the Mercedes review.
What did you think of my driving skills then, Patrick?
Excellent. Very good.
It's... You didn't fear for your life at all?
No, I did not. No. There was no fear of going over the cliffs or over the walls in the harbour.
And look at this luscious interior. You don't do cars like this anymore, do they? Love big old analogue clocks, as you know. And an old cassette player. Well,
modern-ish.
Yeah. Well, thank you, Patrick, for taking us on a spin in your Mercedes, and hopefully we'll see you again in a future video for either Wales or the other car next weekend. All going well.
Thank you.
So, we'll leave it at that for today. Thanks so much for coming along on this journey. Let me know what you thought, and if you'd like to see more videos like this. Patrick does have about 6 vintage cars at his disposal that are running, right? Something like that. So we might take a few of them out for a spin. They're not all automatic like this, so it'll be fun to watch me mash some gears on them. But in the meantime, hope you had a great weekend, and I'll talk to you after. The next video, I promise, will be the Bullet 500 to any 5,000 mile review. Stay tuned. Bye.
Let's get going, Daisy.